All children should be able to grow up to live their best life. One important step in achieving this goal is getting a good education. In many countries, academic achievement is a crucial factor in how much money people will make, how happy they are, and even how long they will live. But what determines how well a person does in school? And why do children turn out so differently, even if they have grown up in the same society? No single element is responsible for something as complicated as education. Instead, a lot of components are involved. One of the most important influences on whether or not children will complete higher education is growing up in a rich or poor family. Surely we can all agree, this is a matter of pure luck. Just as children don't choose to be born to poor or rich parents, they can't choose their genes. But it turns out that the genetic lottery also plays a role in educational success. Scientists study the connection between genes and education by collecting genetic data from hundreds of thousands of people. They look at tiny bits of DNA to see what people who have done well in school have in common. Information about these bits of DNA can then be used to create what scientists refer to as a polygenic score, a single number that adds up the impact of many variables in our genes. It's important to note that no one knows for sure how these bits of DNA work together to make it more likely that one child will do well in school while another will struggle. Unlike conditions that are linked to a single gene, such as certain genetic disorders, educational attainment and the ease or difficulty with which one learns are associated with thousands of different genes. So far, the methods commonly used have been tested only in studies focusing on people whose ancestors came from the same part of the world, in most cases, Europe. But we have learned one thing from those studies. The genes of the participating children are as strongly related to school success as some external factors, like being born into a rich family. These dramatic advances in the science of genetics spark hope. If we remind ourselves that genes can be a source of luck in our lives, we'll find it harder to criticize people who struggle in school for just not trying hard enough. Instead, we will be able to identify children who are likely to have a harder time learning and to provide them with tailored support early on. But the advances have also triggered a heated public debate in recent years. Is research about genes and education dangerous? It could be if utilized in the wrong way. Highlighting the importance of genes may make us feel uncomfortable. We may worry about a resurgence of scientific racism, genetic discrimination, or even eugenics. Indeed, scientific insights can be distorted to support dangerous ideas, such as the notion that inequality is genetically determined. It's important to be aware of the dangers and guard against them. But as with any technological advance, we can also choose to focus on the positive opportunities that the science offers. It can help us shape a more equal society. All learners are diverse, and we need to find ways to support them individually and maximize their potential. The findings from research on genes can help teachers and policymakers to create an environment that allows every child to flourish. So far, most initiatives to improve education have looked only at whether they are helping the average child. Soon, information on a child's genetics and other preconditions can be used to make sure that these initiatives are helping everyone, including the children most likely to struggle. These scientific insights will inevitably affect our lives. We must make every effort to prevent abuse and ensure that, instead, they are used to benefit all children. Especially by recognizing those in need of support, boosting their learning before they fall behind.